Missed Monday's show? Here's the recap, presented by Honda.
Did we learn anything by seeing that video that Jay Glazer and Fox released over the weekend that we didn't already know, or that changes how the NFL will hand down a punishment?
Oh, there will be, I think. It's unlikely to be a mega sanction. It's more likely to be a lesser draft choice or a reduction in where the draft choice is taken, along with significant fine. Patriots are going to claim that this guy was doing what he thought he should be doing to tell the story. There are going to be some people, including several coaches, who are going to say that's a bunch of BS. We haven't heard of this for years. Somebody just bringing a camera into a press box and automatically just taping the sidelines.
What does Jason Garrett have to do to keep his job?
I would argue that as mad as they've been with Jason Garrett, he wants him to succeed. The Jones family thinks very highly of Jason Garrett. If Jerry can't go out there and land the Sean Paytons of the world, and he's got to go with an unproven NFL guy or, you know, one of these younger college coaches, prepare yourselves for the possibility that if they go and they win the divisional game and it looks like he lifted this team up, I think he could give Jerry the sort of edge and the hope and the idea that, you know, maybe we'll bring Jason back.
You visited with Mike McCarthy, and he plans on coming back to be the head coach of a football team.
He's tried to figure out how many people in every organization are assigned to the study of analytics and sort of advanced statistics and numbers. McCarthy was talking about the kind of people he wanted. You know, he wants outside-the-box thinkers. If he's going to get back into it, and an owner and a president, a GM, are going to entrust their organization to him, they want to make sure he's a modern guy, open to a lot of the new things that characterize football these days.
He is Arash Markazi from the LA Times. We've been talking about Philip Rivers and his future here. He's obviously in a contract year. Is there any sense you get from the times that you're around the team what the future holds in store for Philip Rivers?
I think when he continues to have games like he did on Sunday, I think the chances are slimmer and slimmer that he's going to come back. I've always said they need to make a big splash this summer. Whether that's a Cam Newton, and Chris Brockman's going to hate to hear this, it should be their number one priority to find a way to get Tom Brady to Los Angeles. That is the one guy that would move the needle in this city. And I know it's for 2 years, but this is a critical 2 years for that franchise. You're trying to sell season tickets. You cannot have 25,000 people in a 70,000 seat stadium, and that would not happen if they get Tom. So again, we'll see what happens, but they need to make a big splash this summer.
For more Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV or download the Rich Eisen Show app.